Yes, teams on 10, Hall of Famers only tonight. The original Greek god Anthony Koutoufides, potentially the best ruckman of all time. He's a bomber and just lots more weirdness. Yes, teams on 10 in the studio. Nick Butler alongside the former Blue and Giant and now the Hall of Famer of Instagram and social media. Dylan Buckley, how you going, mate? How did you enjoy having the footy back?
Oh, I love the footy, mate. Round two, back in action. There were some big games, some good players, and I can't wait to get into it.
Well, we are a serious show of review, and we will have a couple of moments to have a look at in a minute. Just things that got the juices flowing, got you sniffing the liniment. What do the sports psychs say? They say getting the arousal levels up. So we'll go into those shortly. But firstly, we have some feedback.
Exciting.
We do. Now, we have a email here from murkywaters@gmail.com. G'day, Nick. After a rocky start, I'm starting to see improvements in your show. That's good.
Fantastic.
Start with positive. Just one thing. Surely you'll have to change the name because you don't actually give the teams. That is true. Maybe call it Footy on 10. Thoughts?
Look, thanks for the feedback. We'll keep the name. We love it. So, piss off.
Oh, very aggressive. Now, Murky, I don't think we can say that to our loyal viewers. Look, Teams on 10 isn't so much about giving the ins and outs. Occasionally we'll get some mail. Cripper might tell you, I've got a bit of a hammy deal and I can't play this week against the Cats, and we will report it. But really, the reporting the teams is from a bygone era on TV. You can just go to AFL.com. So our Teams on 10 is about what's going on at all the teams, the characters, local footy, just footy and teams. And
that and just talking about your 41-game VFL career, that's a massive highlight of
it. State league career, VFL.
Sorry, yes. We also had some more feedback, and this one's really exciting because I do like this. This is from Tilt.
Tilt Carter.
And Tilt, he or she says, g'day guys, kind of enjoying the show, positive.
Kind of.
It's a bit like the front bar, just not funny. So I like that one from Tilt. That was fantastic. And looks like we're on the right track.
That's, what do they call it? That's the positive sandwich. Positive, negative, positive. Yeah. Anyway, we'll take that. Good on you, Tilt, the great Tilt Carter there from the Sydney Swans. It's probably not him. Righto, what got you going? Let's roll some highlights like a real respected footy show would and tell me what got you just fired up over the week.
Nothing got me going, but something got me riled up.
Hello, puns.
And that was Matty Rao. He was fantastic. The number one draft pick, he's 18 years of age, and his second game, it wasn't the fact he had 26 disposals, it wasn't the fact he kicked two goals, and it wasn't the fact that he was bullying premiership players. It was the fact that he's running around in the ASICS Career Savers. Now, these boots, there's only two blokes that have worn these boots in the last 10 years, and that is Aaron Sanderlands and Matt Rao.
And me.
Sorry, two good players that have worn these boots in the last 10 years, and that's those players. So, look, that's a boot that you wear when your career's nearly over. He's wearing that in his second game. He's bringing them back into fashion, and it's fantastic to see.
So what you're saying is the lad can play, and unlike you when you started, when you're all about the Insta and wearing the ballerina boots with Nike and trying to look good, this kid's already thinking about his career 10 or 15 years down the track.
He's all business. He's wearing the triple black ASIC Career Savers. He's kicking two goals a game. Training hard. Look at that. Look at his kit there.
What about the high pants? He's gone, Rowley's gone the old grandpa look of really hitching him high, and we like that. And look at that training with intensity. He's a star. He's not going to get the old Cavill Avenue fever up there and be partying. He's dedicated and diligent, and he's a star.
I love him. I absolutely love him.
And other 18-year-olds maybe get the Career Savers going early. Now, mine involves Paddy Dangerfield. Mm. We like danger, and it involves the silk Burgoyne tackle, which I didn't really like, to be honest. Silk's very lucky he didn't get a couple of weeks for that. Ooh! But danger in the past, people have suggested he overplays the injuries and might carry on, and there's a little bit of the old Oscar winner about danger. Well, have a look at this. Gets belted into the turf, straight up he gets. Give me my free kick and I'll get on with it. Very, very tough. That debate about danger hamming up the injuries stops now. And Kane Corns goes on with it a bit. I reckon he's proven it there. Any other player? What do you reckon? Gone for the night?
Yeah, I think so. Look, it looked like he saw stars in that vision. But Sean Burgoyne, I know he got reported. I do not know how he didn't get weeks for that. If that was, you know, myself, not that I tackled, I feel like I would have got probably 4 weeks.
Well, that was the debate on some of the really respected footy shows early on the week. So Silk, very lucky, and the rules have now changed. So if he tries that again against the Tigers tomorrow night, you'll have a holiday. And another one from me, forgive me for being self-indulgent, but
Gorney's
hair. I didn't like the mohawk cut, and I said that. And I loved the fact, this got me up and about, that Gorney shaved it off and then just dominated and had captain's hair and had captain's presence, and he missed the song, but he's dancing anyway. And that, I think, is the difference between winning and losing, having a captain's look about you and shaving off that ridiculous Mr. T do.
We said this a couple of weeks ago. You're a dinosaur. It had absolutely nothing to do with it. He's a fantastic player. Some of the ruck work he was doing there was absolutely incredible. So I think it had absolutely nothing to do with it, but I do like the win from the D's.
OK, on being a dinosaur, my love of footy started maybe in the late 80s when I was only a young fella, but your old man was still running around in the 16. But it really started peaking, and I was a Carlton supporter as a kid, when the big Kouta just started plucking balls with
Kouta
one hand.
Koutoufides, they call it.
Koutoufides. Yep. And this week we've decided to go a bit retro and just leave the current day players alone in their COVID suits because we can't really go near them, and dig up an all-time great. And we gave the Koot a call.
And we did. And in true fashion, you creeped him out. Let's take a look.
That's bloody right.
Righto, Kouta, spray of the day. We love this segment because, let's be honest, there's hardly a spray anymore. But when you started the early 90s, there were some nutters, and you had one in David Park, and he had the old Adam's apple jugular, and he used to spit. Yeah. And what do you got for us? What do you remember?
How did you know that about the spit? I remember my first pre-season game against the arch rivals of Essendon, and we were in front by 3 points with about a minute and a half to go. It was a pre-season game, mind you. It wasn't an actual home and away game. And I had the ball, and Craig Bradley was running across close to the wing, and I hesitated. I was like, do I pass him or not? He was screaming that loud.
Rattles.
I thought, yeah, I'd better just kick him the ball. Well, went off the side of my boot, was sort of inner side, and went out in the full. So Essendon got it, grabbed the ball, kicked a goal, went back to the middle. They got the ball again, kicked another goal, and we lost by 9 points. So first game, I was 18 years of age, I think it was, got into the change room, disappointed in myself, and the jugular vein just came out and actually just gave me an absolute, I did not want to come back and play footy again. But that was normal, because I was used to it from the under-19s with Ross Henshaw and then David Parkin, so it was tough to take, but we just accepted it back then.
Koutoufides has been wonderful.
Well, Kouta, players call, and by popular demand, we had to go back to the 99 prelim. Just quickly, where does it sit in terms of the great wins in your career outside of the flag?
If it's outside of the flag, it's the greatest win ever. I'll never ever forget that day. And I think the Carlton supporters, amongst everything that they remember, if we're not talking about premierships, then they remember that day there.
We're all set up for a titanic final term here in the MCG.
I started in the back pocket, and I was pretty much in defence all day long. And at three-quarter time, I was like, please put me in the midfield, I'm ready to go. I felt like I was in the cage in defence, you know, stuck there. And the call didn't come until in the last quarter. And then I was like, okay, let's go, it's time now. And so I don't know who would have called it in the coach's box, either Parko or Wayne Britton, one of those two, yeah.
Beautiful, let's cue the vision.
I remember this part, Nick. I was on the other side, on the wing, running, going, Murph, do not kick, wait, wait, wait.
Look
and I reckon he's seen me and just bombed it in, and
come
there
on,
I am.
Come on, take it just... on, you've set it up,
Koutoufides!
The perfect kick. Oh, I can still remember like it was yesterday, Nick. I remember running and sprinting as hard as I could, and everything just opened up for me, and there I was, marking the ball. I don't know what Doggy Brown was trying to tell me then, but I was not going to listen. I would listen any other time, the mad dog, but not
this
that
year,
time.
Koutoufides gets it.
Well, you're not getting off the hook yet, because you've just sort of brought the Blues close. They're 5 points down, and we're just going to talk our way through it. We're only going to cut out the best bits anyway, as Big Agate Allen sort of won it. Dean Rice is in there having a bit of an impact, but the Bombers trying to go forward. Murph in there again. There's the Koot getting a clearance. Look at this. Out to Special Fried again. The Blues are going to go forward.
You're doing a good job, mate. You keep going.
Let's just see how it plays
Doggy
out.
Brown,
look at
Doggy's
dumb as teak.
Don't know what he was doing then, but anyway, straight to well. It was a good effort, Doggy.
You are doing an outstanding job here. This is going to be a box set of the players' call, and there's one more highlight to go, so we'll stay with it. We'll stay with it, because this is extraordinary, really enjoying this, mate.
Let's have a look.
So there we go. So Braddle's at 55. He's about 55 years old here, and you've set this up at centre-half forward, mind you. So I tell you what, you're covering some Ks.
Yeah. I didn't have the greatest endurance, but on the day, you don't worry about that. You just think of that ball.
So, Braddle's looking for something a bit funky, and he tries to go in a, who's that, Rats?
Brett Radden.
Rats from 40, distance might be a problem, they need someone here, the Blues! Say it!
Kouta again!
Koutoufides has taken the last quarter by the scruff of the neck.
That's what we want to do.
I'll never forget those words. He's taking the last quarter by the scruff of the neck. My little boy Lucas goes around saying that, so that's a classic call.
You're a legend, mate. Beautifully done.
No worries, thank you.
Gee whiz, Nick, that was a little bit weird. I think you creeped him out.
Well, it's a passion. Gee, he was a good player.
He was.
I mean, as far as single quarter performances, you don't see him like that too much anymore. And Drewy Morfitt's commentary of he's taken this game by the scruff of the neck, and I really got Kouta a bit weirded out then. But he started breaking into a bit of ball by ball too.
He loved it. He remembered it.
Do you tell me the players don't like doing a bit of the players call? I think they very much enjoy it. But on Kouta. So not only was he a star and a Hall of Famer on the field, a bit like you, he's revelled off it. He's been a Dancing with the Star, he's been a gladiator, he's been on the TV adverts, and he's just a good bloke. Let's have a look.
Kouta, two absolute Carlton champions here, two in the fat, mate. It's fantastic. How are you looking, mate? How are you feeling? How's COVID been for yourself?
It's actually been really good. I've spent a lot of time with the family and kids, and it's been able to have me more focus on business. And I've just watched business grow actually during that time. So as much as it was scary at the start for a lot of people, and it's affected a lot, which isn't great, I've just been able to focus just on myself and then growing what I needed to grow.
I kicked three on the G one day.
Did
fantastic
you?
Game. It was
well done.
It was incredible.
Yeah.
Have you ever done anything sort of note in your playing career?
I won a premiership. Did you win a premiership at Carlton?
Dad won three. So yeah, my old man won three.
We're going there. That's
so
a bit harsh.
I've got three in the blood.
Well, when I walked into the footy club, 1990, I was 17 years of age. I walked into this club full of incredible, not only leadership, but guys with so much success, decades of success. Now, remember this, that I wasn't a Carlton supporter. I barracked for Collingwood, and I cried many years. And I walked into this club that I didn't like, but what a great, it was just unbelievable to be able to experience what I did and win that premiership back in 1995.
And that's it, mate. You played in probably the last successful era the Blues have had, which was a long time ago now. What's it like watching on now? The boys aren't probably there yet where they need to be. They're on the right track, but what's your thoughts?
I just wish they could experience what I did. You know, walking into such a successful culture and decades of success to understand how powerful the club was. And everyone wanted to play for the Carlton Football Club. Probably not like that now, but I want them to see and experience the power of the Carlton Football Club. And hopefully soon they will, because when I walked in, it was John Elliott was the president. And I knew that if I didn't win a premiership, that I would not be remembered at that football club. That's how I felt. Mm-hmm. And I felt the pressure of that, but that made me rise to the challenge. And I was able to do that at the age of 22.
You hungry?
One thing I have followed in your footsteps, I think, is a successful transition to the media. you've done terrific yourself. I followed your footsteps. You were my poster boy for that. Dancing with the Stars, Gladiator. Now on Teams on 10. Yeah. Guys like us, you know, we do well, don't we?
I think you're doing better than myself, mate. To be a gladiator wasn't that hard. Dancing with the Stars was just a lucky thing where I got through and won. But two great experiences. But I congratulate you, Dylan. You're way above and have accomplished a lot more than what I have. Okay, off the field.
Off the field, that's it. Kouta, thanks so much for coming on, mate. It's a pleasure to be chatting with you. Carlton great and one of my heroes.
Thank you, Ben. Thank you.
There we go, the Coot. Now, what I love about the Coot is that he was big and athletic and had the beautiful big pecs and the chiselled looks and all that. But he was also highly skilled, not one of these sort of project players. The Coot could do it all.
He sure could. Yeah, I loved his pecs. That was my favourite thing about the Coot. But he hasn't changed. He's still in good nick, isn't he?
Let's see how he goes under pressure in the Tray Challenge. Okay, time for the Triton Trayer Challenge. Thanks to Magic Hand Car Wash, 13 locations across Victoria. Coot now, 226 snags in the big time, but never a kick into the back of the tray.
No, never ever, Nick. Plenty of behinds too in my career. Let's not forget. So I'm just...
Yeah, you're going there. Just remember what you did on the G. High and a bit of a lick of the lips.
Okay.
Okay. And quickly yell the rules, Dylan.
Coot, it's one kick, 30 metres, and just a bit of sanitation, mate.
Magic okay, just car, a little, mate, please.
Just a little bit there, mate.
Thank is that all?
Yeah, that's it.
It's not a bad thing.
I don't think.
It's like reverse resin.
This is a dewy, wet day.
We've got some kiddies watching. Coot, no pressure.
No, never.
Oh, not bad, right. Coot. Oh! There's another 5K off the old chart.
Mate, you may have won a flag, but I won't.
All right. Rooms,
mate. He's got the boots on. Watch out, mate. He's got the boot on. Jack Revolt, mate. Didn't make the distance.
Oh, look at that.
Watch this.
Oh. Are you on now? Are you on, big fella?
Kouta, this is what you call a Brumby.
Oh, let's have a look. Jeez, he's serious. He's got the boots on. He's casual walking.
Oh, not bad.
Oh! The alarm's on.
Oh, no. Let's get out of here.
Right, just for the Blues fans, mate, we're going to get you to do a special. No glove required for you. Can we have the one-handed pick up, the Bruce McAvaney special,
yeah,
and then the kick?
Front spot, Koutoufides too strong. Oh, brilliant. Absolutely brilliant. One-handed, he did it.
There we go, mate.
Tell us, friend.
Just the
ready?
One hand, and ready? Off you go, big Koot. Have a look at Kouta. He's like a big Greek god. Oh, no.
Front spot, Koutoufides too strong. Oh, brilliant. Absolutely brilliant. What about Kouta there? That was magic.
Well, Kouta, close but no cigar, but you were very much on target, and I think you've dented my car another couple of grand, mate.
That's all right, mate. That's all about the game, you know. Part and parcel of the game.
It is all for good television. Now, you That's get a very right. nice prize for being such a good sport. You get a 12-month unlimited Wash Club wow. membership with Magic Car Wash from only $299 at participating locations. Magic Wash Club is, Kout, read that last three there.
Cleaner, safer, faster.
And he's doing ads now. Fantastic. And there's more.
You Thank
also
you,
get the Melbourne bit of titties courtesy of CUB. They
Who's
can go
for?
On. They're for you.
Oh, for me. Okay.
They're
Great.
On, they're on ice until the Blues beat the Cats.
Yep.
And courtesy of Cheeky Monkey down there, Cheeky Monkey Coffee Paradise on Swan Street, you get a coffee pack and a nice breakfast voucher.
Beautiful. Thank you very much, boys. That was unexpected.
Treat yourself.
Oh, yes.
Nicely done.
Beautiful skills, big Coots. And gee whiz, he loves kicking the footy.
I just, can I say you're doing very well holding the prizes too? You,
yeah.
you look comfortable, you sort of hold up the right one at the right
it's
time. So very well done.
And we've got some great sponsors on this show, so we do thank them.
Now, I got a bit of feedback from my father about kicking footies at my car.
Yeah.
He's not impressed.
And just to say, just to set the scene here, you are 37 years old.
Yeah, and I think...
And your dad still yells at you.
He does, and I think he'd like me to be a bit more of a Gerard Whateley type, a respected analyst of the game, which I do try to be, award-winning journalist many years ago. But so he doesn't think it's funny that we kick brand new footies at my car.
And oh, I love it.
He's starting to do some damage, so we'll have a look at that sponsorship team. On that, we've got some live feedback here. We've got another email. And this one's from bullet@gmail.com. Thank you, Bullet. Now, as I read, hi, guys. Well done on the show. Loving the studio look. Well, that's good. That's good. That's good. Dill is very funny, but make sure he wears a nice shirt. Well, that's another tick, because you look like you're going to national service there in your nice nice shirt. And, okay, here we go. Just some friendly advice for Nick, though. It's clear you're very proud of your 41 State League games, but... No one really wants to hear all your boring VFL and Sandful stories. Okay. Also, we don't really want to watch you kicking into the Triton either. Leave that to the real players. Keep up the good work, though. Bullet.
I absolutely love Bullet. I want him on the show. I couldn't agree more because I've actually come across something that's quite embarrassing. And this was in your footy bag that you take everywhere. You say 41 State League games. This yes. is the Nick Butler... Video resume.
Yes, now, yes, the resume.
Is it
that
true?
Camera, son? That camera?
No, I'm right. It's
oh,
no,
you are. You
and,
are. You are.
Is it true that you have been sending this, actually, as an 18-year-old, till you were 25 years old, you were sending this to AFL clubs, and Adrian Dodoro was one that would cop this quite frequently.
They all copped it. It's true. I did. I was desperate to play, and I was a bit like Adam Sandler in Happy Gilmore. Like, you know, I felt good enough, but... In the end, they just had to say, you're no good. But that was, you shouldn't have taken that, mate. I was going to get my wife tried to throw that out, and I retrieved it, and it was my final video resume.
Here it is, here, Nick.
When I was 25. Oh, Butler, look at that. Yes, in the defensive goal square with the glove on.
Can I just say something about this? The thing that didn't get you picked up, it wasn't the way you played, it was the kit that you had on. Yeah. Now, long socks with a shin guard.
You've what about this? Oh, strength and almost fell
said,
over and puts it through.
Not the kit. You've got the skins down to the knees.
Yes, and
a glove.
A bit
of
a mullet.
Haircut.
And a very tight 11. Like, I didn't realise that at the time, but that is, what is that? It's like it's a couple of ones. That's not an 11.
Lucky you weren't playing at Etihad because that ball drop would have hit the roof.
And we can cut out of this soon after my fantastic snap in the wetted Albert and in the prison bars if you don't mind, or maybe hang on here. No, take that.
That's
enough indulgence. Look, that one went off at 25. It's a bit embarrassing, but I wanted to have a go, mate. I wasn't sort of father-son saloon car ride like you. I had to fight. I had to cut up some vision.
It also helped that I had some ability. Now, Nick, something that I do want to see is some junior people cutting up their own clips.
Yes, get into it, lads.
If you have your own highlights tape, please send it into the show. We love music in the background, even some commentary.
Your own commentary. for the junior under 11s, a bit of sort of almost footy legend
even
style.
If you're 25 and you've still got some vision running around, a young Nick Butler.
I went with the white stripes. Dun, 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 to really get the recruiter's attention. Don't know if it did. Adrian Dodoro found it quite funny. So what do we do? Do we DM?
Instagram's a go, what the kids do these days. That's what we're on. So maybe just send us the DM at teamson10. Send us through your video and you'll feature. And you'll even get a Melbourne bit of slab.
And if you're underage, we'll sort you out something.
Some cordials.
There you go. And quickly on Bullet for the boring stories. Well, that's page one. So that's we'll my boring that. Stories we'll list. Dean Brogan, Jack Cale, Spud, Richo, Stevie J.
Anyway, Bonnet. That's fantastic. But we do have something big coming up, and it's the Icon Challenge. Talk us through that quickly.
The iconic moment. We've gone back to my decade again, the 80s. 1985, when men were men and fights were like street fights. And big Simon Madden, he was a gentleman, but he revelled on the big stage.
They're going in now, and Hawthorn are not taking any funny business today. Look at them going in, piling in there. Players.
So there was a bit of a brawl at the side of the game. I've heard.
No,
you.
No, what's this?
A bit of a lover, not a fighter, but got a bit involved.
It's changed now. I think like that would cost today. That would cost us and the club so much money. It just wouldn't happen. But it was almost a show of strength, and there was this great rivalry between the two sides. You know, it was really good, and that was almost a show of strength from one player than another player. And you don't even plan it. It's not if it was planned. You just, all of a sudden, somebody goes in and you come in and the players come from everywhere. So you can't just stand back and go, no, you've got to, yeah, I'm involved. So we all had our moments in the, you know, sort of bit of glory and pushed and shoved or whatever, and then moved on. So they were a very, very good side through a good era, and we beat them twice. So, yeah, we were pretty good. And then 85, we were the best team all year. If you had asked any of the critics at that time, we were the best team. So going into the grand final, you go with a confidence that we probably didn't have in 83.
The Bombers go back into attack over their half forward line, a centre half forward. Flying high was Madden, a beautiful mark.
Great mark. Lundon Smith.
Yes, so I did.
Great, great, great.
I always have a guard, Dermy, because Dermy kicked 8 goals and had a great game, but I won the Norm Smith.
Dermot Brereton, about 30 metres out, directly in front of goal. He'd be pretty nervous.
Their ruggedness, aggressiveness, and the ball is through for another goal. That's his third.
A worthy winner of a wonderful medal to commemorate a wonderful man, Simon Madden.
And so Dermy doesn't like that, but you know, so we have an ongoing little battle about that.
And at the moment, I hear that you're part of a rock band and you're doing some stuff with leadership. Do you want to tell us about that?
Yeah, so I put the ad in, simonmadden.com.au. I do a lot of leadership development, team building, and strategy. So if you need strategy coming out of COVID, I'm the man. But also, I'm in a band. It's a rock and roll band. We do covers of 50s, 60s, 70s, 80s, some 90s. It's the songs your parents would have been playing while you were sitting in the back seat, maybe.
Oh, yeah,
all right.
Sure, definitely.
So there's. If you don't know the song and you can't move your feet, we don't play it. All the classics. And we do pub gigs, we do birthdays, we do weddings, we do whatever you like out there. Look up, Simon Madden, look up, never, better late than never, sorry, not better late than, almost forgot the name of the band. It's been so long, we need to play.
Well, thank you so much for sharing your iconic moment with us. We really appreciate it.
Thank you, and go Dons.
There we go, Simon Madden, what a star. He didn't have to send any highlights tapes. He was the genuine article. And well done to Steph. She's finding some really good form in the reporting.
She's fantastic. We love Steph. She's a part of the team.
Did well in enemy territory, and he's right up and about, Simon. Now, quickly, both our mums want tips. They say, you've got a footy show, you need the tips. So fire away.
They do. OK, we start at round 3, Thursday night, Richmond versus Hawks.
Tigers for me, but I'm wary of Clarkson.
Friday night, Dogs versus Giants, the game of the round.
Scratchy, scratchy Giants for me.
Saturday night, North versus Sydney.
Loving Reese and the Kangas and Jasper, North Melbourne.
Collingwood versus St Kilda.
Good game, this one. Pies, I reckon, genuine premiership contender, a bit ordinary round. Last round, they'll bounce back.
Geelong Carlton down at GMHBA.
Cats at home, easy.
Brisbane versus Eagles.
Eagles bounce back.
Sunday, we have the Suns, my boys, versus the Crows.
This is my little mystery pick. I think Nixie will get the Crows up. I think the Suns might have had a bit of Cavill Avenue fever, so the Crows in an upset.
And the Bombers versus Melbourne.
Demons too fit.
Last game, Dockers versus Port.
Port Adelaide, a really good side. There are the tips. No responsibility taken with your local competitions. Now, next week, have your people been in touch with Dusty's people?
No, they haven't. Dusty's way too good for us, let's be honest.
Any idea of the guest?
Not as yet.
Maybe we'll just go another Hall of Famer because we had two tonight. That was Teams on 10. Enjoy your round of footy and there'll be plenty more laughs and weirdness and good stuff next week.